Hi, hello students. I hope you enjoyed last 2 videos. Today I am going to teach you about artificial method of vegetative propagation. Before I will teach this new topic, I would like you to inform you that share my video, like my video, and subscribe my video. Now, the topic: artificial method of vegetative propagation. Artificial method of vegetative propagation is the way of another type of asexual reproduction, which is mostly done by the horticulturist and the farmer to get good qualities of crops and vegetables. In case of artificial method of vegetative propagation, there are different methods are there, and I will teach you about only 14. Next one is the layering, and third one is the grafting. In case of cotton, suppose this is the stem, and we know that stem have nodes and internodes. When we take the parts of the stem, it should be in our mind that it's contains nodes, and it's caught in the branches, in the branches. Why should we caught in the branches? When it's caught in the branches, it will less damage to the tissue, and maximum area will be covered with the soil. So it should be in the branch cut. Next point will be first will be the branch cut. Then second point, after cutting it in the branch cell, we have to dip in the auxins. Already in the 11th standard you read about the different types of phytohormones, and auxins is the one type of growth hormones. After dipping the auxins, it will be degraded to the roots. If the pericycle of the stem will be degraded to the root. And suppose if the stem is contained another nose, then from the nose of the other adventurous roots will be arises. How cutting is done in case of by vegetative propagation? First it should be in the branch cut, then we have to dip in the auxins. After the auxin dip in the auxins, it will be given to the root. Next will be the layering. Yeah, cutting will be done in case of rose plants. Layering. There are 2 types of layering are there. One will be the ground layering, another one is the air layering. Okay? In case layering, the name itself layering, it should be tossed in the ground. Ground layering is mostly found in case of jasmine plants, and air layering is found in case of the mango plants. Okay? Suppose this is the jasmine plants, and these are the branches of the jasmine. When this branch will be fall on the ground, and that branch contains the nodes and internodes, from the nodes your root will be arise. Okay, and this root will be divided to the other branches of the jasmine plants. After root arises, you can cut the plants from the parent plants. As it is, you will get the new jasmine plants. That is the ground layering in case of jasmine plants. But in case of air layering, what will happen? Suppose this is the mango plant. Okay, in this case, the dead cell of the dead outer covering of the branch will be removed. Dead covering will be removed. Then this part will be covered with the soil. After covered with the soil, it will be tied with the help of cloth or by the tissue paper and allow it to expose to the air. After few days, the root will be arises from this area, and when the root will come out, there will be cut parts of the branches from the main plant, and will be get the new mango plants. That is how air layering is done in case of the mango plants. Next will be go for the grafting. Grafting is the process in which 2 characters of 2 different plants can be found in case of 1 single plant, that is known as grafting. Suppose 2 rose plants are there. 1 rose plant having the ornamental values and other having the defense mechanism. And I need a plant that has the both defense mechanism and ornamental value. Then I have to go for the grafting. In these cases, those having give rise to the root system, that is known as stalk. Those will give rise to the shoot system, that is called the shear. That will be due to the your shoot system. Okay. In this case, grafting, the plant will be caught in the branch cell. But there are 3 types of grafting are there. Okay. Tong grafting, wedge grafting, and crown grafting. In case of tong grafting, what will happen? The diameter of the stalk and shear will be the same. stalk and sphere will be same, and it will be cut in the blunt shape, and both the stalk and sphere will be fixed with each other. Okay, that type of grafting is known as tongue grafting. But in some cases, what will happen? The stalk will be the more diameter than the sphere. In that cases, the stalk having the V-shaped cut, and then the sphere will be fixed under the V-shape of the stalk. That type of grafting is known as wedge grafting. Suppose two or three wedges will be made, then that type of grafting is known as crown grafting. This is your stalk, and here will be put two or three stalk. Then that type of grafting is known as crown grafting. Understood? What is grafting? Grafting is the process where two characters of two different plants will find in case of one single plant. That is known as grafting. And grafting are of three types: tongue grafting, wedge grafting, and crown grafting. In tongue grafting, both the diameter of stalk and sphere will be more or less same. But in case of wedge grafting, the sphere diameter will be less than the stalk. But in case of crown grafting, more of three wedges will be found in case of the your crown grafting. These are all about your activation method of vegetative propagation. Now, your time is to like my video, share my video, and subscribe my video. Okay? Now next will be sexual reproduction in case of organisms. The sexual method of reproduction is finished. Now sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, detail about the sexual reproduction will be read in the next chapter. In this chapter only you will be get the terms what are used in the next chapter. So what is sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction is the process where two organisms give rise to the gametes, and the gametes are fused and form the zygote. And zygote will develop into the embryo, and embryo will give rise to new organism. That is known as for sexual reproduction. Then what will happen? In sexual reproduction, two organisms are created. One will be the male, another one will be the female. Male gives rise to the male gametes. Male gametes in case of animal it is known as sperm, and in case of female the gametes is known as ova or egg. Okay, when the sperm and ova, the gametes will be fused, they form the zygote. They form the zygote, and zygote will divide and redivide and give rise to embryo. There are certain organisms are there like your earthworm, which having both male and female's reproductive part in the same organism itself. That type of organisms is known as hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite animals, where both the male and female reproductive part in the same organism, then it is known as hermaphrodite. But in case of human beings, what will happen? Male is different organism and female having a different organisms. But in some organism they have the both male and female in the same organism. That organism is known as hermaphrodite, and example is the earthworm. Okay. Male organism, male reproductive part give rise to the sperm, female reproductive part give rise to the egg and ovum, and it will be fused to form the zygote. And that process is known as your, from this to this process is known as your embryo. This process is known as gametogenesis. Gametogenesis. The formation of gamete is known as gametogenesis. Then the formation of zygote to the embryo, that is known as embryogenesis. Embryogenesis. How your zygote will be converted to embryo, that process is known as embryogenesis. In total, common will be known as your gametogenesis, but the formation of sperm from the male is known as spermatogenesis. The process is known as spermatogenesis. Okay? And formation egg from the female reproductive part is known as oogenesis. Oogenesis. And it is a very slow process compared to our plants. These are how in the case of the animals the sexual reproduction takes place. Now the sexual reproduction in case of the flowering plants. In case of plants, what will happen? Both the male and female reproductive part is found in case of the same plant. And that part plant
known as monoecious plants. If both male and female, flower is a bisexual flower. And that plant is known as monoecious plants. In case of dioecious, unisexual flower. There are the unisexual flower. Suppose in case of rose flowers, both the male and female flowers will be found in case of the same plants. So it is known as monoecious. But in case of dioecious, like a papaya, the male flower bearing plant is different from the female bearing plants. So they are known as dioecious plants and unisexual flower. Monoecious plants, again, both the male and female reproductive part in the same flower. That is known as bisexual flower. Suppose the flower having only stamens. The male reproductive part is known as stamen. If only stamen is present, then that type of plant is known as staminate. Okay? If only pistil is present, then that type of plant is known as pistillate. Understood? In case of dioecious or unisexual flower, if only one stamen is present, then that type of plant is known as staminate plant. And only if the female reproductive part is not present, then it is known as pistillate plants. Understood? These are all about your monoecious, dioecious, bisexual and unisexual. In the next video, I will teach you about the other terms used in case of your sexual reproductions. Thank you, children. Don't forget to share my video, like my video and subscribe my video. Thank you all.